Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is a Saint Laurent collection video. I'm going to be sharing with you everything that I own from Saint Laurent. I'm obviously going to be covering handbags, but also accessories and SLGs as well. I am going to be ranking everything in order of my least favorite right through to my most favorite. A little caveat with that though, I would say that everything I own from Saint Laurent I really love, and if I don't love it, I usually just sell it. So all the items remaining in my collection I do still really enjoy, and the ones at the bottom of the list are only there because something has to be. So I'd say I love everything I own from Saint Laurent. I'd actually probably say it's my favorite brand apart from Chanel, and that used to be Louis Vuitton, but just Saint Laurent I feel like have been killing it in recent years, and I just love the items I have from them. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and let's get started. So I'm going to start off with accessories, and first up is my brooch. And I would say that even though I do like the accessories I have, I definitely like them a little bit less than the bags I own from Saint Laurent. So this is in true ranking order. So the first up is my brooch, which I do really, really like. I think it's beautiful, but I would say I feel like it falls down on functionality just a little bit, just because the pin is a little bit thick, and I like to typically wear my pins on blazers and scarves, things like that, and they do usually have slightly thicker fabrics, and if the pin is too thick, it does make it a bit trickier to get in the fabric. The other brooch I have, which is from Chanel, has a very, very thin pin, which makes it much easier to put on pretty much anything, whereas the thicker pin, whilst it makes it very sturdy, it does make it a little bit trickier to pin on items. So I love the look of it, but I wish the pin was thinner. So that is the reason why I don't wear this probably as much as I should. But in terms of the look, I think it's great. I love the metal design. I got it in the gold, but you can get it in silver as well. I just think it's beautiful. So like it, but I do think that the functionality could be improved a little bit. Next up are my card holders. These are the only SLGs that I own from Saint Laurent, but I obviously really like the style because I own two of them. So I have one in the red and one in the white, both with gold hardware, but these are so great. They fit a surprising amount for something so slim because there are so many pockets. So you have two pockets on the front, two pockets on the back, and then also a pocket in the middle as well. So plenty of space for all of your cards. I love the leather as well. It is that pebbled grain leather, and it's just so easy to maintain. You know, if you spill anything, it just wipes clean. Very durable and hardy, and I just love these for that reason. And even though these are still, you know, luxurious items and they're priced as such, especially when you compare it to, you know, Chanel and Louis Vuitton, I do think these are more competitively priced than other items from other brands. So I do really like these. I do also have a giveaway coming up on my Instagram within the next 7 days, so definitely within the next week, for a black one of these. So if you're interested in winning one, then I will link my Instagram down below. Keep an eye out, it will be going live within the next week. So first up is my Saint Laurent camera bag, and this I'm kind of cheating with because I'm excluding it from my other bag ranking just because I've only used this once and I don't feel like that's enough to get a proper idea of how functional it is and how much I like it. So this is being excluded from the ranking. I will say that the one time I did use it, I did really enjoy it, and obviously I liked it enough to buy it in the first place. I love the look of it. I love the fact that it looks kind of vintage looking, but at the same time still very of the moment. I think it's a beautiful design. I love the gold hardware. I do think it makes what is a quite casual bag. You know, the camera bag style is a casual one. I do think it does well at making it a little bit more dressy, which in turn makes it more versatile, I think. And it's very comfortable to wear because you do have the leather strap also. The capacity is decent. I wouldn't say it's huge, but I could fit in my essentials. And I love the fact that you do have the little card slots there. So I feel like it's kind of a wallet on a chain design in a very small way. So I love that. I also really like how low down the zip goes, so you can actually open the bag very wide, which means you can fit more in. And yeah, I just really like this. So again, can't say too much, only a very brief kind of first impressions, but so far so good. I'm a huge fan of the Saint Laurent leather in general. I never had any issues with it, and I think it's a beautiful style. So next up is my Saint Laurent wristlet in the Mock Croc, and the only reason why this ranks slightly lower than the other ones is because I do feel like it's priced more on the high side. It is under £500, but only barely. I think it's £475, which for something like this, even though it's beautifully made, I do think that's quite a lot of money for a wristlet. So I love it, and if you love the design, you know, there's nothing wrong with it, certainly, but I do feel like it could have benefited from being just a little bit cheaper. That said, it is pretty functional for what it is. You can fit a surprising amount in here. I typically use this for dinners out, and it has plenty of room, so I fit in my phone, a lipstick, keys, my cards, and that's really all I need. You do have lots of slots as well, which makes it very, very easy to access. So it does have a wallet on a chain element as well. Plenty of room, lots of compartments, and yeah, it's just very functional for what is, you know, a little wristlet. So I really love this. I would say that I do wish it came with gold hardware. I always really prefer gold hardware, but that's the only thing I think I'd really change about it, apart from making it a little bit cheaper. But if you like Mock Croc, this is a really nice option because I do think it does it in a very subtle way. And yeah, I do really like my wristlet. Next up is my Saint Laurent Velvet Lulu, which is coming up very dark on camera, but it is a beautiful burgundy color. I love this bag so much, and I've said this before, but I really think Saint Laurent do the best velvet on the market in terms of bags. Their velvet is so plush and luxurious, but it still wears very well as well. And I just love it. So, huge fan of Saint Laurent's velvet. This one is such a gorgeous style, and I was really debating whether to put this in this ranking, but to be honest, all of the bags I'm talking about from here onwards and really in the whole video, I just all really enjoy. So it's a tricky one to rank, but this one is very, very cute. You do have quite a few compartments inside. Again, with the card holders, you have a pocket on one side, a divider in the middle. I would say if I was gonna change the design, I'd probably remove the divider in the middle. I'm not typically speaking a fan of dividers, just because I think it really reduces the capacity of the bag, so I would always rather do without a divider, but that's a minor niggle. It closes with a button closure, and it's very easy to close. And I just think this is the most adorable thing. I would say I don't find this quite as versatile as my Saint Laurent Sunset bag, just because that one's black, a bit more neutral. This one I do feel like is a little bit more casual in terms of velvet bags. Velvet bags in general I do think are typically more dressy, but I do think this one sits on the more casual end of the scale, and that is helped by the fact that it does have a little leather strap as well. So only good things to say. I really enjoy this bag. I think it's beautiful, a little bit festive in its look as well because the red, but yeah, just a stunning little velvet style. Next up is my Saint Laurent Uptown Clutch, and this is a newer addition to my collection, but this has fast become a favorite. I wasn't sure about it at first because even though the price is pretty good for a luxury bag, this is priced at £345, I was worried about the capacity and if I could fit anything inside, because as you can see, that's a pretty slim clutch. But I can fit in my phone, my cards, my keys, and a lipstick, and it doesn't bulge out too much. And obviously it's going to depend on how bulky your items are, but I've not found it to be an issue. I love the magnetic closure as well, so it's very easy to open and close. I love the look of it. I think it looks way more expensive than it is. I think that you'd never really guess that this was under £500, let alone under £400. And I think this is a really, really nice choice if you did want a luxury clutch, but you didn't want to spend a ton of money because, you know, they're not something that you use every single day. Yes, it's still a luxury purchase, but for the value you're getting, I don't think it's too bad. So huge fan of this. I've not had any issues with the smoothness of the leather. Obviously, I haven't had this for years, so I will update you guys if I have any issues, but so far so good, and I am super, super happy with this purchase. This one does come in black and also Mock Croc as well, so another nice option if you did want something Mock Croc. I just got mine in the white because I wanted very specifically a white clutch, and I'm just very, very happy with this choice. So huge favorite from Saint Laurent. I love this one to bits. So I have three bag styles left, and I really debated what order to put these in. They're very, very close. I enjoy all three styles a lot, and they rank very highly in my overall bag collection. But I've gone with what I think is the right order, subject to change. But coming in at number three is my Saint Laurent shoulder Lulu bag. I love this style, and actually most of my Saint Laurent bags are more on the mini side. I don't really have any larger ones, and this is my only kind of larger style from Saint Laurent, and I really, really love it. I think it's so great. Again, if I was going to pick something different, I'd probably make the hardware gold, as I always would, but that's a standard thing with me. I don't have a ton of silver, and I would say this is more kind of like a gunmetal style, but I also like the variety, so maybe I wouldn't change it, I'm not sure, but in general, I love this bag. It is so light and so comfy to wear. It is like carrying a cloud pretty much. It does have that pillow look, which I know some people hate. I love it, I think it's amazing. And the leather, which on other styles I have seen to be quite delicate, the leather here is just very, very durable for whatever reason. So I've had no issues with scratches. I'm trying to find anything wrong with it and I can't. Like, it's just done very, very well. I've not babied this at all. And more than that, I don't feel the need to baby it. You know, some bags you get the sense that you really have to take care of them. Whereas this, I just haven't felt the need to be overprotective because I just don't think it needs it. So I love the fact that I can just carry this and be worry-free. It opens up like so. I did eventually take off the blue sticker that was on there for a really long time, but I have now taken it off. It's very, very roomy, so it has plenty of room for all of your items. It has one zip pocket as well, Saint Laurent stamping. The front flap can get a little bit marked, but that just wipes clean, so very easy to maintain as well. Very easy to close. It is a button closure which has a magnet, which is, I think, my favorite style just because it's so easy. And yeah, I just love this though. I love the comfort, I love the look, and it's just fully converted me to larger Saint Laurent bags now. And coming in at number two is my Saint Laurent Sunset bag. And I would say I do think that this has been a grower. I always liked it, but I seem to like it more with time, which doesn't always happen with every bag with me, but it certainly happened with this bag. I think I mentioned in my favorites video, I wanna say, that when it came to dressing for the cold weather, this was the bag that I was most excited about using in terms of kind of more winter appropriate bags. I love it. I think it looks so chic. It's very easy to wear. So I typically wear this crossbody, but you can wear it doubled up as well. You know, it's very, very versatile. I love pretty much everything about it. It is tiny though, so you can't fit much in at all. Again, it has that divider, so you are very limited on space, but I don't mind shrinking down my belongings for this bag because I think it looks so great. So I am a huge fan of this, and I really wasn't a fan of the larger Sunset bag, which I did buy in the pink leather and then returned it. I found that overwhelmingly heavy and just not comfortable to carry at all, whereas I really don't have that issue with this one at all. So I love this. I love the velvet of it. It's worn pretty well considering, and I have used this bag a lot. I've had no issues with the velvet at all, actually, and overall, it's just a great bag. So huge thumbs up for this one. One of my absolute favorites, just such a stunning style. And coming in at number one is my Saint Laurent clutch. I love this bag so, so much. And I think this was actually the first bag that I got from Saint Laurent. So this is the oldest in my collection. I've gotten a ton of use out of it. It's still my go-to event clutch. I love the functionality. I love how hard wearing it is. This is the one with the very sad burn mark. And if you watch my other videos, then you may have heard me say about that, but it got burnt at a wedding, which is very sad, but that has not stopped me from using it, mainly because it's also on the back and at the bottom. So I wish it hadn't happened, but again, it's not going to stop me from using this bag. And apart from that, which I don't think we can blame Saint Laurent for, the leather has done incredibly well. And I do hear people say that they've had bad experiences with Saint Laurent leather, but I just never found that to be the case. I've not had a single issue when it comes to their quality. And maybe I've just been very lucky, I'm not sure, but certainly in my experience, I've not had any complaints, I've not had any stitching issues or leather issues, just nothing at all. So I love Saint Laurent leather. I find it to be very durable and hard wearing. In general, that is, because I know Saint Laurent do offer a few variations on their leather. The Jamie, I know, is very, very delicate, but in terms of their pebbled grain leather, I've only had really great experiences. I think it's so easy to maintain, which makes it the perfect event clutch, because you can put it down on a bar, and if you do get a drink or something on it, you just wipe it clean and you're good to go, you know? On the inside, it has a fair amount of capacity. Obviously, this isn't a huge bag, but you have a ton of card holders, like a ridiculous amount, and you have two compartments and then a zipper pocket in the middle, and you also have a chain as well, which is great if you do want to be hands-free. So in terms of an event clutch, I do think this is a great option. If you were looking for a go-with-anything clutch, I don't think you can do much better than this. The Uptown clutch is obviously great if you did want to save a little bit, and I was actually contemplating getting another version of this in the white, but then I saw the Uptown and I was just too drawn to the great price. So both good options. Obviously this is quite a bit more, so this is priced at 1050, so It is a substantial jump, but I wouldn't trade this clutch at all. I think it's so wonderful, and I do think it's just very, very classic looking. You know, the YSL logo isn't going anywhere at all. It's been around for a long time, and I just think they make really stunning and beautiful bags. So if you wanted a go with anything clutch, I do think this is a great option that you'll just be able to wear for so many years. So that is it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I will leave links to everything I featured in the description section below, but if you do have any questions for me, then leave me a comment. If you like these collection videos, please do give this a thumbs up. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I will see you in my next one. Bye, guys.